Hello. Today's subject is basically just going to cover how to be poor. A lot of people are poor who were not previously poor. The economy being the way it is, people who have never been poor before now find themselves in a position where they have to learn quickly. For most of my life, I've been poor, so I just put it right out of my mind. I could lose my health insurance at any time. I could be homeless. I could need money for anything and not have it. Late in the month, I have to buy gas for the car, so I buy, like, you know, $2 worth of gas. When I used to live in Lawrence, I used to buy cigarettes for my girlfriend at the time, one at a time. They're called Lucy's. Just buy one. These are things that poor people do. But people that don't know how to be poor, well, it's kind of sad. So here's a couple of pointers. We'll call this the Halloween edition because Halloween is coming up. In the last couple of Halloweens, I believe we went dark because we had nothing to give the kids. And you can't bake kids anything because then they think that you're trying to poison the kids. So, and you can't afford candy because at that time of the month, it's like period. It's a bad time of the month. You have no money on the 31st. So, first thing you do when you're poor, never miss a doctor's appointment, ever, because you're lucky to be receiving health care. So, just, you don't miss them. You go. Medications, always take your meds, because God knows, you don't know when you'll be getting them. B12, gotta take it, never miss it. I don't want to get the scurvy. And so there's some things there. That's not much though. This is called folding money. And when you get to a certain point of the month, this is sweet to find when you're looking for change. And you find folding money. It's beautiful. Okay, so it's Halloween night. You don't know what to give the kids. We grew tomatoes this year. And we had a lot of extra tomatoes. They were green. They just turned red. So what we're going to do is, I'm thinking, freeze them and give all the kids frozen tomatoes. If not, I'll just give them a tomato. It'll be considered strange. It'll just be considered strange, so I may not do that. Cheap candies like Smarties. Again, kids won't be happy to see it, but, you know, they can go suck an egg. Sometimes you get, like, ramen noodles, and you don't want the flavor pack that comes with it. Just give that to the kids for Halloween. They don't care. Or if you have things around the house, like, you know, seashells. Again, you're putting something in the bag. They don't know what it is. Could be something good. So, to sum up, old extra recipe things, bad candies. I believe these are made by Necco. Necco wafers, one at a time, or And if you're really out for money, you can open this up and give them one smarty at a time. This tomato here is looking a little rough. So if somebody dresses up like Mitt Romney and they think that they're funny and cute, I can give them a really shitty tomato. So that's that idea. Another thing, solid white tuna. You can kiss it goodbye. You'll be eating this from now on. Now I like solid white. I can't eat chunk white. Nancy likes it. If she didn't eat it, I'd be giving it to the kids for Halloween. But it looks like tomatoes, shells, Smarties, and chicken flavor packets from ramen noodles. That'll be going to the kids this year. Because that's just the kind of guy I am. And, you know, I'm a man of great standing in my community. See? I'm an elected representative, Precinct 1. I can't just shut the door and turn out the lights and not give things for Halloween. This is a holiday for the kiddies to learn just how poor their neighbors are. I guess that's it. That's all you're getting.